Hello dear students, namaste to all. How are you? Hope you will be fine. I am once again in front of you, myself Subhash Chandra. Today we will study the 11th class business studies. So we will start our syllabus from the very first unit. And the first unit consists of four chapters. So first chapter is, this is unit 1. And chapter 1 is, this is called as 1.1, because there are four chapters, so we will denote first chapter 1.1, second 1.2, third 1.3, and fourth is 1.4. So chapter 1.1 is business, an introduction. So in this chapter we will study about the business. So first of all, the term is human activities. Human activities. The activities conducted by human beings are called as human activities. It is very simple. In our daily life, every time we are busy in doing some work, in activity. If I am teaching you in front of camera, that is also human activity. You are seeing the video, that is the human activity. If a person is sleeping, dancing, playing, running, or always engaged in any activity, so all such activities conducted by human beings are called as human activities. And human activities can be divided in two categories. First, economic activities. And second, non-economic activities. Economic and non-economic activities. So first, economic activities. Economic activities are those which are done to earn money, to earn profit. Whatever activity is conducted by a human being to earn money, that will be termed as economic activity. If I am teaching you, that is also economic activity, because in lieu of that I will get money. If a person is running a business, if a person is a doctor treating his patients, he charges fees. So any person who is engaged in an activity to earn money, that will be called as economic activities. And non-economic activities. Non-economic activities are those which are undertaken either to provide service to others or to get mental satisfaction. These activities are not meant to earn money. For example, if a housewife cooks food for her family, so her motive is not to earn money. She gets mental satisfaction. She is serving her family. A teacher teaches his own son, or a boy is helping a blind woman in crossing a road. So his motive is not to earn profit, not to earn money. So that will be also non-economic activity. So these activities are done either to get mental satisfaction or to provide service to others. So we will study the economic activities. So these activities are undertaken to earn money. And economic activities can be divided in three categories. First, business, profession, third is employment. So these are the three economic activities. So we will study all these activities one by one. So first is business. तो व्हाट इज ए बिजनेस? ए बिजनेस इज एन इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी विच इज कंडक्टेड और विच इज कंसर्न्ड विद प्रोडक्शन, सेल एंड परचेज ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज ऑन रेगुलर बेसिस टू अर्न मनी. द मोटिव, द पर्पज ऑफ एवरी बिजनेसमैन इज टू अर्न मनी. तो टू अर्न मनी ही इज एंगेज इन सेलिंग सम गुड्स, इन प्रोवाइडिंग सम सर्विसेज. सो व्हेन सच बाइंग एंड सेलिंग टेक प्लेस ऑन रेगुलर बेसिस, रेगुलरली ही इज परचेजिंग द गुड्स फ्रॉम सप्लायर एंड सेल इट टू द कस्टमर्स, तो दैट विल बी कॉल्ड एज बिजनेस. इफ बाई चांस इफ ए पर्सन इज एंगेज इन सच बाइंग एंड सेलिंग बट दिस एक्टिविटी इज नॉट कंडक्टेड रेगुलरली, तो दैट विल नॉट बी कॉल्ड एज बिजनेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यू परचेज्ड ए मोबाइल फोन, इट कॉस्ट इज ₹10,000 एंड आफ्टर टू डेज यू सेल इट टू अदर पर्सन फॉर 12,000, तो यू अर्न ए प्रॉफिट ऑफ 2,000. तो दिस एक्टिविटी विल नॉट बी कॉल्ड एज बिजनेस बिकॉज दिस एक्टिविटी इज नॉट कंडक्टेड ऑन रेगुलर इंटरवल्स, रेगुलर बेसिस. तो फॉर ए बिजनेस रेगुलरिटी इन डीलिंग्स इज रिक्वायर्ड. इफ ए पर्सन सेल्स मोबाइल्स ऑन रेगुलर बेसिस, ही परचेजेस एंड सेल इट, देन इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज ए बिजनेस. तो नाउ वी विल स्टडी द फीचर्स और कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ बिजनेस. फर्स्ट, एन इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी. तो फर्स्ट फीचर ऑफ बिजनेस इज इट इज एन इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी. इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी मीन्स द बिजनेस इज कंडक्टेड टू अर्न प्रॉफिट, टू अर्न मनी. यू विल नेवर लिसन अबाउट ए बिजनेस विच इज गोइंग ऑन और विच इज रन टू प्रोवाइड सर्विस टू अदर्स. जब भी हम दूसरों को सर्विस, सोसाइटी को सर्विस प्रोवाइड करने के लिए मनी इन्वेस्ट करते हैं, तो दैट विल नॉट बी कॉल्ड एज बिजनेस. The business should be always to earn money. We are engaged in buying and selling of things only to earn money. So, a business is an economic activity. Second, exchange of goods and services. So in business, various kinds of goods and services are provided. Like as a trader, cloth merchant, he purchases cloth from the supplier and sell it to the customers. So that is exchange of goods. Sometimes services are exchange, service providers like electricity companies, water supply or other transport services, banking services, insurance services. So any activity which is engaged, which is concerned with exchange of goods and services will be called as a business. So this is the another feature of business. Now third is regularity in dealings. One more thing about business is that whatever sale and purchase take place, that should be done on regular basis. If such buying and selling take place at once, even money is earned, profit is earned, it will not be called as a business. It requires regularity. When on regular basis we sell goods or we provide services, that will be called as business. Fourth point is profit motive. Another feature of business is the business is run to earn money, to earn profit. The objective of every business will be to earn profit. And it is not certain that profit will be earned. He may incur loss also. But objective is only to earn money, only to. You see, in today's scenario, The businessmen are not earning profits. Business are totally closed down. They are paying electricity expenses, rent of the shop, or so many, even salaries. They are also paying salary to employees as per government rules. They are incurring losses. So we now also we will term it as a business. Instead of profits, they are incurring losses. And last is element of risk. So in every business, there is always some type of risk, whether the degree of risk is small or large. If we are running a business at very small scale, there will be less risk. What is the meaning of risk? Risk means chances of losses or inadequate profits. Sometimes instead of profits, we incur loss or profits are not sufficient. So that is called as risk. And this risk is arises due to uncertainty. Future is uncertain. So in every type of business, there is risk. If business is of large size, there will be largely degree of risk will be large. So these are all the features of business. Now the next topic, next type of economic activity is profession. What is a profession? It is also an economic activity. A profession is that economic activity under which a person provided his personal services on the basis of his knowledge and experience for serving the various sections of the society. He charged fees in lieu of that, like as a doctor, a lawyer, a chartered accountant. They provide services and in the form of remuneration they charge fees. So for a profession, special knowledge is required. Without knowledge, without degree, without skills, a person cannot enter in any profession. So we can say that it is an occupation. It needs a specialized body of knowledge. So a business is that economic activity under which a person provides his personal services on the basis of his experience, on the basis of his knowledge, to earn money. So now we will study the features of profession. First is specialized body of knowledge. First thing for every profession is having special knowledge. If the person is not having the special knowledge, he cannot enter into the profession. He have some skills, he have some guts in mind. If a doctor treats his patients, so he is having some special knowledge. Every person cannot become a doctor. He has some skills inside him. So for every professional, he must require the special or specialized body of knowledge, skills, capabilities. A lawyer also, when he fights the case of his clients in the court, he is having the knowledge of all sections of Indian Penal Code or other legal requirements. He is having special knowledge. The second feature is formalized method of acquiring training. For a professional, it is compulsory whatever skills he is having, such skills must be acquired in a formal way. Informally, if a person is having knowledge, so he cannot enter in the profession, he cannot be termed as a professional. Like for a doctor, it is compulsory that he should be MBBS, and the degree of MBBS he has taken from any मेडिकल कॉलेज आफ्टर टेकिंग एडमिशन, उसने MBBS की डिग्री एडमिशन लेके किसी मेडिकल कॉलेज में एडमिशन लेके पास की है। फॉर ए लॉयर ही शुड बी LLB, उसने LLB की डिग्री फॉर्मली एक्वायर की है। कोई घर बैठ के डॉक्टर नहीं, जैसे किसी डॉक्टर के पास बैठ गया 2 साल के लिए, वहां से नॉलेज ले ली और क्लिनिक ओपन कर लिया, तो दैट विल नॉट बी कॉल्ड एज प्रोफेशन। फॉर ए प्रोफेशन इट इज कंपल्सरी दैट वट एवर नॉलेज और स्किल्स इज रिक्वायर्ड, दैट नॉलेज एंड स्किल इज एक्वायर्ड इन ए फॉर्मल वे। थर्ड फीचर इज फॉर्मूला, ये एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव प्रोफेशनल एसोसिएशन। फॉर एवरी प्रोफेशन देयर इज ए प्रोफेशनल एसोसिएशन एंड एवरी प्रोफेशनल इज बाउंड टू टेक मेंबरशिप, टू टेक लाइसेंस, to take permission from the representative professional association, like for doctors, Medical Council of India, MCI. And I think the MCI is terminated by the Modi government and a new association has been made this time. I think it is ICMR. The new name of MCI is ICMR, Indian Council Medical Research. तो फॉर एवरी डॉक्टर और एवरी पर्सन हु इज इन द प्रोफेशन ऑफ मेडिकल, ही हैज टू गेट द लाइसेंस, ही हैज टू गेट द मेंबरशिप फ्रॉम ICMR। फॉर लॉयर्स देयर इज द बार काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया, एवरी लॉयर, एवरी एडवोकेट हैज टू गेट लाइसेंस फ्रॉम बार काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया, अदरवाइज ही कैन नॉट स्टार्ट हिज प्रैक्टिस। फॉर चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स मेंबरशिप इज रिक्वायर्ड फ्रॉम ICAI, ICAI means Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. So for every professional there is a professional association whose membership is compulsory to take by every professional. Without membership no person can enter in any profession. Next is code of conduct. For every profession there is a code of conduct. Code of conduct means some rules, some regulations that bind the behavior of the professionals. For a doctor, code of conduct is he should give priority to service to the society. The economic consideration should be secondary. कोई भी डॉक्टर है उसकी प्राइमरी ड्यूटी क्या है? इफ any serious patient come to the doctor, many a times we see that doctor says first deposit rupees 1 lakh, 2 lakh, then we will start the treatment. That is against the code of conduct. The primary duty of every doctor is to provide service. The profit motive hai, economic consideration wo secondary hai, money will be deposited later. So there is a code of conduct, means rules, regulations and guidelines which are necessary to follow by every professional. And last is service motive. Another feature of profession is service motive. The primary motive of every profession is to provide service to the society. एवरी पर्सन इंटर्स इन दिस प्रोफेशन टू अर्न मनी। कोई भी डॉक्टर जब इतना पैसा खर्च करके डॉक्टर बनता है तो किस लिए? वो पैसा कमाने के लिए। बट एज पर लॉ द प्राइमरी ड्यूटी इज टू प्रोवाइड सर्विस, टू अर्न मनी इज सेकेंडरी। द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ अर्न मनी इज इन केस ऑफ बिजनेस, बट इन केस ऑफ प्रोफेशन मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव इज ओनली टू प्रोवाइड सर्विस, प्रॉफिट इज सेकेंडरी। Now, the third economic activity, we are studying economic activities. First is business, second is profession, and third is employment.
एम्प्लॉयमेंट,
रोजगार. तो व्हाट इज एम्प्लॉयमेंट? इफ आई एम टीचिंग यू हियर, इट इज एम्प्लॉयमेंट, इट इज नॉट प्रोफेशन. सो एम्प्लॉयमेंट इज दैट इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी अंडर विच ए पर्सन वर्क्स फॉर अदर्स इन लियू ऑफ सम सैलरी, इन लियू ऑफ सम रेमुनरेशन. ये वो इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी है जिसमें एक पर्सन किसी दूसरे के लिए एज ए सर्वेंट काम करता है सैलरी के बदले. इफ ए पर्सन इज डूइंग ए जॉब इन फैक्ट्री, इन ए बैंक, इन ए स्कूल और एनी वेयर, दैट विल बी कॉल्ड एज एम्प्लॉयमेंट. तो द पर्सन हु इज गिविंग द जॉब विल बी कॉल्ड एज एम्प्लॉयर, एंड हु इज गेटिंग द जॉब will be called as employee, and the contract between employer and employee will be called as employment. If a teacher teaches in a school, it is employment. On the other hand, if he has opened his coaching center and he teaches students and charges fees, then it is not employment because he is not working any other person, under any other person. So that will be profession. In the same way, if a doctor is working in a hospital and getting salary from the hospital, the fees from the parents is charged by the hospital and doctors are paid salary, then it will be called as employment. But on the other hand, if a doctor has opened his own clinic and charges fees from the patients, that will be called as profession. The features of employment, service to others, so in employment the employee provides service to others, others may include employer or others. So in employment the person who is engaged, he provides his personal services, he works as a servant, he works according to the directions of his master, of his employer. Second is agreement. For employment, agreement is required. Agreement means whenever two or more persons make a contract, means a person makes a proposal in front of others, one or two people, and they accept the proposal, that will become an agreement. So in case of employment, this agreement is between employer and employee, and all terms and conditions are agreed and signed by both the parties. So such agreement is called as maybe in the form of appointment letter. Whenever an employee is offered the job, he is given the appointment letter. In appointment letter, every terms and conditions relating to the job, relating to the employment are mentioned. Okay, what will be the salary, what will be the time, duration of job, working hours, reporting time, departure time, leave, sale or other, every activity, every terms and conditions are mentioned in agreement. Third is servant. So in case of employment, the person who is engaged works as a servant of his master, some servant of his employer. So whatever directions are given by his master, he has to follow the directions, he has to follow the orders. Next is no need of capital. In case of business, large amount of capital is needed. When we want to set up a business, large money is required. In case of profession, less amount of capital is needed, like as a doctor, a lawyer. Lawyer के लिए capital की क्या requirement है? उसने office rent पे ले लिया, वहाँ table रखी है, chair रखी है, that is his capital. But in case of employment, there is no need of capital. If a person is doing job, तो he does not invest even a single penny. All money is invested by the employer. So another feature of employment that it does not require any capital. Next is no risk. In case of employment, there is no risk on the part of employee. If loss is there, that will be on the part of employer, on the owner. He definitely get his salary. If he is doing the job, he will get the salary. So in case of employment, there is no risk. Next is nature of employer. The nature of employer may be either government, semi-government or private. If a person is doing government job, the government is the employer. There are some sectors which are in semi-government under which some money is invested by government and remaining is amount invested by the general public, private persons like LIC or others. And it may be private also. If a person is doing private job, the employer will be private. And last feature is qualification. So in case of profession, qualification is required as per the nature of job. If a teacher is appointed, he must be having proper degree like his master degree, B.Ed or other. For a doctor, he should be MBBS. For a lawyer, he should be LLB. Or for ordinary worker, I think no special education qualification is required. For a computer operator, special other qualification is needed. Engineer ke liye wo B.Tech is needed. So qualification required for the employment is according to the nature of job. In case of business, I think no qualification is required. We see that even illiterate persons are running a very large size business. So that's all from today. We will wound up, and next time we will continue this. For today, thank you. Have a nice day.